हाय, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू द सेकेंड सेशन ऑफ इंग्लिश ग्रामर फॉर क्लास 8 स्टूडेंट्स। आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द फर्स्ट चैप्टर इन द फर्स्ट सेशन। सिंस वी लैक सर्टेन टीचिंग एड्स एंड इंटरेक्शन इन द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस, we are not in a position to get your doubts clarified, so you may note down your doubts and get it clarified when the school reopens. Okay, let us come to the text. Before moving to the second chapter, let us just recall what we have learned in the first chapter. We have mainly learned about phrases, clauses, and arrangement of words in a sentence. Phrase is a group of words. These words together convey a specific meaning, but not the complete meaning. Phrase has no finite verb. What is a finite verb? Also, we have seen verbs which are limited by number, person, or time are called finite verbs. Then we have seen clause. A clause is a group of words that contains a finite verb and forms part of a sentence. Independent clauses, dependent clauses, conjunctions, all these things we have seen. Okay, now let us come to the second chapter, nouns. You have been studying about nouns from your class first onwards. What is a noun? A noun is a naming word of place, people, animals, things, events, qualities, and states. Nouns can be simple to understand, because any name of a person or a place or a thing is a noun. We know so many examples of nouns like boy, bench, pencil, love, Lucknow, India. All these are examples for nouns. Now, nouns can be broadly classified into two under the heading of concrete nouns and abstract nouns. We can divide nouns into you may have a look at this. Okay, let us see what is concrete nouns. Concrete nouns have material body. They can be seen or touched. With our five sense organs, we can experience them. Concrete nouns means it is material nouns. We can experience them through our senses, sight, hearing, smell, touch, or taste. This is what is concrete nouns. For example, cats, tables, chairs, buses, teachers, all these are concrete nouns, which are very tangible, which we can see, touch, all these things. Now, these concrete nouns are having different kinds. We have seen in the chart. First one is common noun, second one proper noun, and the third one is collective noun. First one, common noun. A common noun is a name given in common to every person or thing of the same class or kind. If we say in another words, common noun is the generic name for a place, person or thing in a class or a group. Commonly we call them. Okay, some examples are given there in the text. The boy is reading a book. The boy is reading a book. In this example, boy and a book. Book. These are the common nouns. Second example, lions and wolves are wild animals. Lions and wolves are wild animals. Lions, wolves, and animals. These are the common nouns we have used in this example. Commonly we call these animals lion or another section, wolves, and together for all the animal kinds we call animals. Next one, we should grow more trees and plants. Trees and plants, common nouns. There are many big cities in our country. There are many big cities, cities and country. These are the common nouns here. These words given above in bold type, okay, in the text when you read you can understand, are used in common for every person, place or thing of the same kind. These nouns are called common nouns. Okay, I hope you understood what is common noun. Now, the second topic, second point, proper noun. A proper noun is a specific name for a person, place or thing. It is a specific name. In common noun, we have seen that it is a common name for the things. Here in proper noun, it is a specific name for a person or a place or a thing. It means it is not generic, not generic. In other words, we can say a proper noun is the particular name given to a common noun to identify it from others of its class. I repeat. A proper noun is the particular name given to a common noun to identify it from others of its class. For example, if I call Suresh, okay, only Suresh may stand up in the class. But boys, that is a common noun. Suresh is also a boy. Okay, that is what is the difference. Okay, individual name, particular name, specific. That is what is proper noun. In the text, there are some examples given for the proper noun. All are very familiar with these proper nouns. Jawaharlal Nehru was a great leader. The name Jawaharlal Nehru. Next one, New Delhi is the capital of our country. New Delhi. I have read the Bible. The Bible. All these are examples for the proper nouns. Okay, if you observe or if you go through the text, you can see these proper nouns are given in capital letters. Okay, always the proper nouns are capitalized in English, no matter where they fall in a sentence, maybe in the beginning or in the middle or at the end, wherever it is, we use the proper noun in capital letters because they project the name with a specific, they project the noun with a specific name. That is why we use them it in a capital letters. Okay. The distinction between common and proper noun is usually quite easy to make. When we speak, it makes no difference whether a noun is a proper or a common. But when we write, we need to know which nouns are proper because we need to know where to place the capital letters. In spoken English, it doesn't mean much. But in written language, we need to be very careful that we have to write the proper nouns in capital letters. Means maybe the first letter and all. Maybe the first letter in capital letter. Okay. There are some examples given there in the text that I have read. Apart from that, in the above sentences, Jawaharlal Nehru is the name of a particular person. New Delhi is the name of a particular place. The Bible is the name of a particular book. So, these nouns are proper nouns. Now, let us move to the collective nouns. A collective noun is the word used to represent a group of people, animals, or things. Some examples are given here. Our army is on the move. Our army is on the move. Army, a group of soldiers are coming under this army. Together we call them army. The teacher is not in the class. Class is the collective noun here. Class means a group of students. Next one, a herd of cattle is in the meadow. A herd of cattle is the collective noun here. In the above sentences, army, class and herd are collective nouns. Army is a collection of soldiers, while class is a collection of students. A herd stands for a collection of cattle. Collective nouns used for people. I have noted down some collective nouns. You may note it down. Collective nouns used for people. A band of musicians. A board of directors. A choir of singers. A class of students. A crowd of people. A gang of thieves. A panel of experts, a team of players. These all are examples for collective nouns used for people. Now, collective nouns used for animals. a flock of birds, an army of ants, a flock of sheep, a pack of wolves, a pride of lions, etc. Now, collective nouns used for things. A bouquet of flowers, or a bunch of flowers, a fleet of ships, a forest of trees, a galaxy of stars, a pack of lies. These all are examples for collective nouns. And when we use collective nouns, many are in confusion whether we have to use singular verb or plural verb for the collective nouns. Collective nouns usually take a singular verb because they are singular in construction. Collectively we call it together. But sometimes they take plural verb when they take individuals separately. When we take it as a whole, we use a singular verb. And when we take the individuals of that group separately, we use plural verbs. I'll give you an example. The committee is on a meeting. The committee is on a meeting. Committee means a group of people joined for any purpose. Committee. Okay, the committee is on a group. In a committee, there can be 5 or 6 or 7. Something like that, people will be there. The members of the committee are on a meeting. You may note down the difference. The committee is on a meeting. The committee is together as a group, single one. Committee is on a meeting. And the second example, the members of the committee individually, separately, the members of the committee are on a meeting. So collective nouns usually take singular verbs because they are singular in construction, but sometimes they take plural verbs when we take individuals separately. I hope you understood all the 3 points which are coming under the main heading of concrete nouns: proper noun, common noun, and collective nouns. Now, we can see what is the abstract noun. Nouns we have divided mainly into 2, concrete noun and abstract noun. Under the heading concrete noun, we have seen 3, proper noun, common noun, and collective noun. Now we can see what is the abstract noun. Abstract nouns are words that name things that are not concrete. Your 5 physical senses cannot detect an abstract noun. You cannot see it, smell it, touch it, hear it, or smell it. In essence, an abstract noun is a quality or a concept or an idea or maybe even an event. Unlike the concrete nouns, the abstract nouns are not tangible, intangible it is. It is an intangible concept or ideas or whatever it is. With our sense organs, we cannot touch or feel or identify the things. Such nouns are called abstract nouns. Okay, I'll give you some examples for the abstract nouns. Beauty, bravery, compassion, confidence, ego, fear, maturity, all these things are abstract nouns. Anger, adoration, despair, sadness, satisfaction, etc. These all are examples for abstract nouns. Okay, this is what is the first part of the second chapter says. Okay, let us just revise this chapter. And the second part we will see